Hello everybody, welcome back again to Mr. Wisp 254, and it's my pleasure to have you join me today for today's lesson. So today I want us to go through how we can be able to configure hotspots. And before we do that, we want to configure this and we want also to use the RADIUS server. So for that to happen, you need to come to systems, and you need to come to packages and ensure that you have a package by the name UserManager installed in your package list. I think in the next video, probably I'll show you how to install packages such that if you don't have UserManager, you can be able to install this so that it can work for you. So the next thing that I want us to do now is I want us to create a bridge. And for this bridge, I want us to have all ports that we are going to use for hotspot. Those ports are going to be in this particular bridge. So let's just call this hotspot. Apply. Okay. So I'm going to use port 2, 3, and 4. So let's add our ports. Ether 2, the bridge, this goes to hotspot bridge, okay. Let's add the second one, Ether 3. This goes to hotspot bridge, okay. And the final one, Ether 4, which also goes to the hotspot bridge. Okay, so for those of you who will be doing this using routers that have Wi-Fi capabilities, ensure that you also add the vlan to this bridge that you've just created. And after doing that, you also need to come to wireless security profile. Then you need to ensure that the mode here is none, such that you don't have any password set for your Wi-Fi device. So let's click OK on that. Let's get this out of the way. Let's also close this. So the next thing that I want us to do is I want us to assign an IP address to the bridge that we just created. So you go to IP addresses, then you come and say add, and the IP that I want us to use, maybe let's say 172.20.100.1/24, and this is going to be on the hotspot bridge. So you apply that, click OK. Let me just put this down here because at some point you are going to use this IP address. So after doing that, the next thing that I want us to do is we now need to come to hotspot. So for you to go to hotspot, you need to come to IP hotspot. Then you need to come to the servers tab. And then from there, you need to click on the hotspot setup. So let's do the setup. So the hotspot interface, this goes to the hotspot bridge. Then click next, next. The IP range looks okay, next. Next, next, next. So for the DNS name, you can basically put whatever it is that you want, because this is a link that probably a client will be able to input on their browser so that they can be able to log in to your hotspot. So let me just name this Mr. Wisp .wifi .login. So I'm going to click next on that. Password for the user, I'm going to use a simple one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Next. And setup has completed successfully. So that is what you need to do. And the next thing that you now need to do is you need to come and now open this. Sorry, not that. You need to come and to the server profile tab. Server profiles. Then you need to open on the setup that you've just completed setting up. Then come to RADIUS and make sure that use radius has been enabled. Then after that, you just click apply. Okay. Let me see if I'm missing something else. Nothing else. Every other thing should just remain as it is. So click OK on that. So after that, the next thing that I now want us to do is I want us now to set up the RADIUS server, the configuration. So you need to come to RADIUS, incoming, and make sure that it's set to accept. Then click OK on that. Then let's add. So the service that we are interested in, guys, we want to do hotspot. So you need to click hotspot, and our address we are going to use 127.0.0.1. Basically, this is MikroTik's loopback address. And for the password, I'll also use a pretty simple password for this. I'm going to go with something like 12345. And we are going to use this secret and address at some point. So just make sure that you have this in mind. So we are going to click OK on this. And that is done. So after that, now the next thing that you need to do is you need to go to your browser so that you can be able to log into the user manager. And how you do that, this is how you go about it. You now come to your browser. And now this is where the IP that I told you about is going to come into play. So we are going to use this particular IP, the IP for the hotspot bridge that we created, which is 172.20.100.1. So that is what we are going to use to log into the user manager. So it's 100.1/userman, then click enter. So this is the page that you're supposed to get, and the credentials, the login is just admin, and for the password, for the first time, it's just empty, so just click login. So this is where you're now going to be able to create your vouchers for your clients and do all those kinds of setups. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first thing that you need to do is you now need to add your router to this user manager. So how do you do that? You come to routers, then you need to come to add, then new, and now the name we can maybe give it Mr. Wisp Hotspot, and then the IP address is going to be 127.0.0.1. So this IP and the secret is going to be 12345. I'm getting those from the RADIUS that we created over here, this IP and this secret. So that there is where I'm getting my credentials from. So after doing that, just click add. Oh, so I can see it's giving me an error saying operation failed. Let me show you how you go about that. So what you now need to do is you need to come back to your MikroTik router, because I had set it up once and I actually deleted it. So what the MikroTik does is when I reset my MikroTik, the user manager was not reset. So for the user manager that I used previously to be reset to default, what you need to do is you need to come to the new terminal. After that, what you now need to type is tool user manager, enter. After doing that, you now need to just say clear. Let me do that once more. What I need to say is database. clear. So it's going to ask you if you want to clear, to reset the whole user manager database. What you're now going to do is you're going to say to say yes, which is Y, and now it has already been reset. The next thing that I want us to do, I also want us to clear the logs. So I'm going just to say database clear log. And for that, I'm also going to say yes, and it has already been cleared. So that's all that you need to do to avoid that error. So let's just close the terminal. Let's also close this. Let's close this as well. So let's go back to our browser. So now when we say add, we should now be able to add. So let's first of all just refresh the page. Then let's say add. If the problem still persists, let's go ahead and restart our MikroTik router. So you need to come to System, Reboot. Yes. So let's give it a minute or two so that it's able to do the rebooting. So as you can see, the router is already reboot. So let's go back to our web browser. Let's refresh the browser once more so that we can be able to log in. So the login details are just admin, no password, then login. So we are going to go to routers, add, new. We said we give this Mr. Wisp hotspot, and our IP address is 127.0.0.1. Our secret is 12345. Then click on add. So you can see that now the operation has been completed successfully. So the next thing that you now need to do to add your customers, you just need to come to customers. No, not customers, actually. You need to come to profiles. So here is where now we want to set up our profiles and our limitations. So you need to come to profiles, then click on add. So let's give this a name. We can give it maybe, let's give it a name. Let's say five or maybe, let's just use gold as the package name. Then create that. After that, we now want to add a new limitation. So you need to come to right here and click on add new limitation. Then what you now need to do is click on new limitation again, then give it a name. So let's say I'll give it maybe, let's say gold again. And then what we now need to do is we now need to set the rate limits. So for you to be able to set the rate limits, you just need to come and click rate limits. And what we now need to do is maybe we want to set this to 1 megabyte and 1 megabyte as well for the download. After doing that, you click on add. Then after doing that, you need to click on add again. Then after doing that, we now need to save this profile. So the profile has already been saved. So the next thing that we now need to do is we now need to add the number of users who will be able to use this package. So you can add one user, you can add multiple users. So let's go ahead and do that. So you need to come to users, then you need to come and click on add. So this is where you're going to be able to choose if you want to do a batch or you want to do just one user. So let's go with one user for now. So let's say this is gold user. You can be able to use, you should be able to use any name. These names are just for demonstration purposes. Then after doing that, we now need to give this user a password. Let me give the password, let me set the password as 0987. Then after doing that, we now need to assign a profile to this user. So given that we only have one profile created, which was gold, it's the only one which is available. If we had more, from the drop-down, we would be able to choose other packages as well. So we are going to choose gold for that, and you are going to click add. So the user has already been added, and that's basically how you add your users. And now let's try and test and see if it works. So you can remember that we did configure our ports, and we did port 2, 3, and 4. So I'm just going to switch my cable right now so that I can be able to plug it on either port 2, 3, or 4 and see what happens. So let me just open back my browser, because after doing that, because I'm using a cable, it should just prompt me directly and it should redirect me to the captive portal where I'm supposed to now use this user that we created, user gold. So let me just do that. Yes, you see it has just done that on its own after changing the port. So right now I'm connected to the port where hotspot has already been configured. So what I now need to do is I just need to input a username which we created, which was user gold, and the password that we created was 0987. So what you just need to do is click on connect, and you should be able now to let me see the user. What was the, no, the user was gold user, not user gold, gold user, sorry for that, gold user, and the password was 0987. Connect. So you see we've already been redirected to the internet and we have internet connectivity. So guys, that is how you are able to configure hotspot. And I'm sure from the user manager, there are a lot of other settings that you can be able to do. You can create a batch of vouchers. You can just choose to create users one by one. It's all up to you. So that's how you go about it. Thanks a lot for joining me for today's lesson, and I'm looking forward to see you in the next one. So please leave a comment, tell me if this video was helpful to you, and if you encountered any problem, also let me know so that I can be able to assist you. Thank you and bye-bye.